Viewer discretion is advised.
Previously on Hell's Kitchen, 15 aspiring chefs.
Hell yeah, baby.
Came face to face with a slightly different Chef Ramsay. And didn't even know it.
I'm the Black Gordon Ramsay.
After making a poor first impression,
get in there.
They got a second chance.
What is that?
Hen in a pumpkin.
I'd like to stick your head in there, you know that?
Plain, blonde, and boring.
But blew it. At dinner service.
What are the five entrees?
The men didn't know the menu.
What?
And neither team had much success cooking it.
I just want to go with some food!
Dominic!
In the red kitchen.
Who cooked this?
Corey struck out with her chicken.
It's rubber!
In the blue kitchen.
Is anyone going to take control?
Bobby deserted his team.
I don't want to jump in. You don't need eight set of hands?
Use the...
Lou Ross had to nominate two of his teammates for elimination. And while the blue team made a recommendation...
Bobby.
Chef Ramsay had the last word.
Dominic, take off your jacket and leave Hell's Kitchen.
Tonight, the quest to become the executive chef at Gordon Ramsay's new L.A. restaurant continues. And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
I feel bad Dominic got picked. I didn't think he was gonna get picked.
Dude, I seen it coming, I'll be honest.
I was trying to lay it back.
You done taking it easy?
Yeah, it's on. I dodged a bullet tonight. You know, I had this laid-back approach, but it's gonna be a new Bobby. You know, the four-star general got to come out now.
Yeah, that was so intense. I had fun getting yelled at every 3 minutes. I didn't realize what I was getting into. I took a beating tonight. That ain't happening next time. If I have any say-so whatsoever, I don't lose the girls, especially a bunch of young little kids. That ain't happening again.
I vote we kill it. We've already said the bitches are in the next kitchen, so let's prove it. We beat the boys, which is great. Seems like the guys need to cut some of the dead weight anyways. And they had a lot of choices.
After a disastrous dinner service, all the aspiring chefs want is a little sleep. And that's exactly what they're going to get.
Let's go, everybody! Wake up! Let's get down!
Bullhorn started, and he started yelling.
Yeah, come on, move!
Unpleasant, I'll tell you that.
No!
Come on, get up, get out of here, let's go!
Let's go, get dressed, get downstairs go. Now! Go, come on, go, 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 go! Come on! Good morning.
Good morning, Chef.
With everything we wasted last night on service, any restaurant would have gone out of business. You have to understand what you put in the trash last night. Hey, guys, up. I've never seen so much fantastic produce wasted. Now, every rubber chicken breast, every rock-hard potato you binned last night, get it out and put it back in the cylinder. Move. Look at it all. Come on, guys.
Chef Ramsay's lesson about waste is one our aspiring chefs find a little unsettling.
People were flopping around in it, and their bare feet, just disgusting, butt cracks all showing, and just, it was nasty.
It's only food, Jenna.
Come on.
Look at the waste.
We found all kinds of food in that trash. I mean, excellent cuts of beef, scallops. It's all expensive food. It's a shame we had to waste all that food last night.
Sharon, don't smudge your makeup.
You're disgusting.
disgusting.
Okay, get on the stairs, all of you. Now! You should be ashamed of yourselves. We're not talking about a couple of hundred dollars. We're in for thousands of dollars there. Carelessly just put in the trash as no one gives a f-. You all better start giving a damn. Now, go and get showered and meet me in the kitchen. You stink.
Now the chefs are about to learn that waste can happen before the cooking even begins.
We clearly understand what it's like to waste produce. Now, I'm going to show you how to maximize on it. Challenge today. Halibut. One of the most sought after, delicious fish today. Watch carefully. Raise a sharp knife.
Chef Ramsey demonstrates how to properly prep halibut.
One fillet, done. Skin off.
Lastly, Chef Ramsey cuts the halibut into 53 perfect 6-ounce portions.
There we go. The team with the most perfect 6-ounce portions, to my standards, wins. Scott and Gloria, bring in the halibut, please. Are we ready?
Yes, 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 Chef.
20 minutes, starting from now. Come on.
Each team will have 20 minutes to properly prepare as many 6-ounce portions of halibut as possible.
Come on.
Come on, guys.
On the blue team, catering director Petroza takes the lead on filleting.
Make love to it, Patrizzi. Make love to that fish, man. As long as I'm around here, I'm gonna be that loud mouth little boy. This is gonna be like, come on, make that look sexy. Let's make love to the fish. Come on.
Beautiful thing.
They already got one fillet off.
Don't get nervous and rush. We got 20 minutes.
Chef Ramsey has chosen this challenge because not only does it stress attention to detail, but teamwork as well.
Take this tail from here to here.
I'm just trying to get the bone right here. I got it.
You got it?
I got it. Just let me get this bone and I'm good.
You talk to somebody and they're confident about doing a project, you know, you got to put a little faith in them.
10 minutes gone, 10 minutes to go.
Just cleaning it up.
That's money in the bank.
Guys, done.
The men have finished with plenty of time to spare, while the women continue at their own pace.
Don't worry about them being done. We have plenty of time.
I was getting nervous because the guys were finished. My hands were shaking. I was just like, okay, let me cut this right and not cut myself.
Slow down. We got time. Take it down. Sharon, she just don't know what she's doing, so she needs a lot of coaching.
Trim that up. Trim that up.
Deemed redemption right there.
Last minute. Let's go.
Come on, ladies. Let's go. Let's go.
You know what a 6-ounce feels like, right? Yeah, 6 ounces.
Good job. Blue team, good job.
Come on, Sharon. You got this.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Ladies first. Intact, whole, nice. No bone, no bloodline, good. Gashed. Beautiful.
Although the women took longer to fillet the halibut, it appears as though taking their time might be paying off.
In. Not bad.
Thank you, Chef.
Good job, girl.
Okay, Craig. Let's go. How many, Bobby?
I say 50, Chef.
50. You only need 42 to win. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. In. Oh. It's like a chain of sushi. Who's doing this? Who's butchering it?
I believe who ripped the fish actually was Jason.
Beautiful. It's like it's been chewed up.
Oh, man.
Come on.
Who's been eating this?
Who did that?
Look at it. You finished early. You clearly rushed it.
We thought we had 50 portions in there. By the numbers, it looked like we had an edge. And you know what? We did have an edge by the numbers. What beat us down was inconsistency in the quality of the fillets.
beautiful.
It's nice.
In.
Despite mangling several portions earlier, the men's numbers are starting to add up.
In.
35.
In.
36.
In.
37.
In.
38.
In.
39.
In.
40.
In. We have a tie.
For the first time ever in the history of Hell's Kitchen, a challenge has ended in a tie.
Now, I want each team to decide one individual to come up to the front of this table and select a 6-ounce portion of halibut. The team with the closest to 6 ounces wins the challenge. Decide. Let's go.
Corey, when I told you 6 ounces, you marked it on the spot.
Who's coming from the blue team?
Big Ben!
I've portioned a lot of fish. When he said, who wants to be chosen? I was like, it's me. Put me in the game.
Who's coming from the red team?
Before I was about to choose the fish, I felt like I was going to have a heart attack.
First time ever in Hell's Kitchen, a tie break. Now, I need a winner. Both of you, pick up your fillet.
Come on, Big Ben.
Ben.
Sir.
Fillet, from the blue team, on the scales. .9 ounce.
You know, ain't no way in hell that them girls gonna weigh a perfect 6-ounce piece.
Wait, guys. She still has to do hers.
Corey.
My team chose me to make the decision because I did an awesome job portioning the fish. Every fillet that I did, I know was 6 ounces.
To break the tie in the halibut challenge, each team picked one member to select a perfect 6-ounce fillet. Ben has come extremely close.
5.9 ounce. Well done.
Thank you.
Now the women's fate rests, literally, in Corey's hands.
Corey.
Sorry. I felt more embarrassed than anybody because I was the one that chose the fish. It sucks so bad, like, it's just depressing. And we're already, like, so tired, you know.
That sucks. How hard can it be to at least get close to 6 ounces? Because it's really not that hard. And it's like, that pissed me off. I don't know what we were thinking in picking her.
Ladies. I explained that you did not want to lose this challenge today. You'll now be prepping all the halibut, making all the fish stock for the service, and maximizing on every portion. Gentlemen, we will be overindulging. All of you will be joining me on a 100-foot super yacht. Now, your Rolls Royce and your Bentleys are awaiting you. Go and get dressed.
Baby. Good job, Blue Team. Good job.
The boys came all freshly from their shower to go on their yacht.
Leave it out. Make it fly. Make it fly. Bye.
They started slamming their Cleavis down, spraying us with lobster juice. You know, I have a pretty expensive cologne on.
Whose house?
Our house!
Our house! Shut up.
You can keep your house because we're going to the ocean, bitches.
Yeah! Oh my God!
I've never been in a Rolls Royce. I don't think I've ever looked in the window of one. It was definitely cool.
Gentlemen. Gentlemen, welcome to your day of decadence.
I've never been on any kind of boat in my life. The only boat I got near to was the Love Boat on TV.
Take a seat. Enjoy.
The lobster lunch blew me away. It was phenomenal.
Excellent. We've got the best of the best. Congratulations. Well done, huh? Halibut. Well done. Let's get some caviar in, shall we? JP.
I look around, it was Jean-Philippe. He's rocking this navy blue suit and like a little scarf. He looked prestige.
What do you think the girls are doing?
While the men enjoy their reward on the high seas, back in Hell's Kitchen, the women's punishment has them feeling pretty low.
For the record, I called it. I said that damn filet was too little.
It's not Corey's fault. It's all of our fault. We're a team.
Sure.
Jen said that, no, she was pretty much thought it was my fault. Don't call me out in front of everybody. It just makes her look stupid. So I think her personality is just to kind of blame others.
Get the hell up out of this kitchen, boy. Of course, she has a small brain. She knows she messed up. Damn. And now I'm covered in fish guts and stink and funk. Damn.
To the blue team. 5.9. Don't lose a challenge. Next service, you have got to attack it.
It was pretty cool we get to talk to Chef. I mean, he's at the top of his game right now. He's a pinnacle.
Who's got?
Who's got?
A new day dawns in Hell's Kitchen, and with it, the chance for both teams to put their determination and knowledge to the test.
Corey, you're mixing up recipes. Put that into that machine, yeah?
Yeah.
Then add the Tabasco, the lemon juice, the glucose.
Our team has a problem right now, just worth sharing. It puts us at a really big disadvantage.
Sorry for bugging you, Corey, but I never made this before.
Fellas, how we're feeling?
Good, man.
Good, good.
I am very confident that we're gonna win. We're all very serious, we're all closer, we're all communicating.
Yes, we need mascarpone for the risotto, too.
That's okay, he just said we can get more if we need it, so don't sweat it. I don't think the girls have a clue what they're doing. But what do you expect without a man over there to lead them, of course?
Classic vinaigrette. The formula is 1-to-1 ratio, champagne vinegar to EVO salt pepper.
Christina is a know-it-all. Her brain is big and filled, but her mind is so weak.
Oh, coming around hot, heavy.
A room full of girls, I mean, that's useless, unless, what are they having, a Tupperware party over there?
Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Hop, how are we? Good. Okay, before we start, Petroza.
Yes.
The menu. 5 appetizers. What are they?
The appetizers, Caesar salad with fresh anchovies and seared tuna.
Stop.
Yes.
Stop.
Yes.
Do me a favor. Get out. Hey, look at me. Upstairs, hey, and read that menu. And listen, your station stands unmanned until you get your together. Hurry up. Is it really too much to know the menu inside out? Eat, drink, sleep, breathe it? I've got 3,000 dishes between my ears. Pathetic. First night service. It was horrific. It was miserable, and I've never seen Jean-Philippe take such a battering. Tonight, one from the ladies' team, one from the men's team is going out there to be an assistant maitre d'. Okay, men's team, maitre d', assistant, deputy, Craig. You're working front of the house, yeah? You've got the gift of the gab?
Yes, chef.
Yeah?
Yes.
Ladies?
Yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
Roseanne?
Yes, chef.
Tonight, you're gonna be handling 120 customers.
Okay, chef.
Let's go.
Tough day, tough start.
It just hasn't been sinking in just properly. It's probably been 19 years since I had to go by somebody else's menu. Just not used to studying, just period. It's really bothering me.
Troza. You in the storeroom. Do you think we're here for a no, close the door, please. Out.
I'm leaving, sir.
Good, thank you. What is this? What is this, a Comedy Central?
No, sir.
You're now on the verge of making me look stupid now. Do you understand? From the desserts up, what okay. are they?
All right, the Valrhona chocolate and the Valrhona chocolate and black cherry sorbet.
There is no black cherry sorbet.
There's no black cherry. It's there's some in the black.
It is a Valrhona chocolate fondant with black cherries.
Okay.
Upstairs and start again.
Okay.
Quick, let's go.
Okay.
Can you hurry up?
Yes, sir. Yes, chef. You think that you're strong? You think you're bulletproof? But nah, not yet.
Nah, I'm done.
I'm done. I'm done. In the words of Chef Ramsay. Hey, I'm done. I'm done.
It's okay.
I'm done.
No. Come on. Put it down.
No, I'm
chef
done.
Watch you.
Man.
Chef, watch you. He's not right out there. It's okay. Come on, let's go. Get it together. Pull your jacket. Come on, let's go. You all right? Take a couple breaths. No, it's cool. Stay right there.
I'm done, man.
No, stay there. You're cool.
No, I'm done. Yeah, I'm done.
It's just minutes before Hell's Kitchen is set to open, and one chef may be out before he even starts to cook.
You all right? Take a couple breaths. No, it's cool. Stay right there.
Done, man.
No, stay there. You're cool. Chef's spending this much time with you. Here, wipe your eyes. Here, this is the cleanest thing. Here.
I'm good.
Wipe your eyes.
Petroza, you know, I like him for some special reason, you know, because he has a genuine heart. You know, I felt him, you know?
He likes you. I told you last night, he has some strange reason he likes you.
I was feeling defeated. I was a shell of a man, but I am gonna press on hard and give every single thing I've got.
Okay, right, we off. Fire me. Sing to me.
The grilled filet mignon, the cannon of lamb, the chicken, and the pavé of salmon.
Now, get in the kitchen. You're on
and
the meat.
Work my off.
Jean-Philippe, open the doors to Hell's Kitchen, please. Let's go.
Yes, chef.
Tonight, as Hell's Kitchen opens for the second time, Jean-Philippe will be assisted in the dining room by Craig from the Blue Team.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, my name is Craig. I'll be a server tonight.
And Roseanne from the Red Team.
Need some orders. He's going to explode. He's going to explode in 2 seconds.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Chef Craig. On order, 4 covers, table 6, 2 crab with risotto, 1 scallops. Entrees, 1 lamb, 1 beef, 2 halibut.
Yes, chef.
I want a louder. I want to hear this brigade perform tonight.
Yes, chef.
Thank you. Let's go.
You ready?
Ready.
Good service, too smooth for the groove, right?
Right.
Let's go.
While the men get to work on their first tickets, the women have yet to receive an order from...
Roseanne. Come here, madam. Right now. We're now 37 minutes in. 2 tickets in the blue, nothing in the ladies.
Okay.
Move your ass.
Yes, sir, chef.
Let's go.
While the women wait, the men are already sending appetizers to the pass for Chef Ramsay's approval.
Guys, come here a minute. Bobby, now.
Yes, chef.
Come here, you. Yeah. Is that the best we can do, fry egg in Hell's Kitchen?
Nope.
No, chef. Yeah.
Look at that there. Oh, come on, Bobby.
Bobby is on the appetizers, but to get the scallops out, he will have to rely on Jason, who is on the fish station.
Come on, guys, you guys are killing me.
Bobby, I'm gonna fire the scallops. I'm firing the scallops right now.
Did you put an egg on? Did he take the scallops already? Don't fire any scallops. If I don't say fire scallops.
I didn't fire scallops.
Well, I don't know. They just magically appeared. Don't fire scallops. If you hear me say...
You put those over there 5 minutes ago.
Gentlemen, let's not argue.
You had to cook them. You had to cook them. If I say fire scallops, don't fire scallops.
Stop arguing, man. I can't...
You just cook. Don't you worry about us. You cook.
Bobby tells me to... fire his scallops for him. I hand him his scallops, and then he don't want them because he's too busy breaking eggs, and then he tries to blame me for.
You guys, I'm gonna give you these eggs the last time. Please assemble them right. You guys breaking these eggs.
Chef, order up.
On order, ladies, concentrate. First order, 4 covers, table 41, 1 risotto, 1 scallop, 2 Caesar salad, entree, 1 halibut, 1 chicken, 2 beef, 1 beef medium well, 1 beef normal.
Yes, chef!
Let's go.
45 minutes into dinner service, and the women finally get to work on their first order. In the Blue Kitchen, the men's second attempt at appetizers has met with Chef Ramsay's approval.
Service, please. Wait, come on, you. Wake up, you.
And they're making their way out to the dining room.
Risotto. Thank you.
Fortunately, it's worth the wait.
I really like scallops.
Meanwhile, none of the red diners have received their appetizers.
Guys, risotto's up. Two risottos, one on the fly.
But Corey is working quickly to change that.
Corey, very nice that risotto.
Thank you, thank you. I know that like I have the leadership skills, and I was honestly like super impressed with myself.
What a difference from the last service.
Yes, chef.
After a slow start, the women are hitting their stride. But over in the Blue Kitchen, the men have served all 48 of their appetizers and are now looking to get ahead with entrees.
Albert, where is it?
Yeah, I'm ready. Let's go.
Even from here, Jason.
Yes?
It looks raw.
I don't think it's not
Let's
raw,
have a
Jay.
Cook.
It's a little more raw than you wanted it. Yes, chef.
A little? Okay.
Come here. No, I got it.
Shut up. Just touch that. Because he'll think I'm picking on him.
No,
let's go.
No, I don't think you're picking
It's stone cold and it's raw.
I get pissed off when people don't get the food out, you know?
I mean, we can pretty much bend over and kiss our asses goodbye.
Have you got thin pieces of halibut? Stop!
Yes, yes.
So they won't take 7 minutes then, Jay.
Okay,
I'm trying to help you.
Yes, I understand.
They're ready, you're not.
Okay.
Where's the beef?
Okay. There you go, chef. The play's already
It's not even hot. Come here, Petroza. Oh, here we go. Touch that. You, touch that. Please, touch that. There you go. Touch, 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 touch.
It's rare. It's rare. And he's my fire.
Petroza! Oh, come here, Petroza! Touch that.
An hour into dinner service, and no entrees have left the Blue Kitchen.
It's rare. It's rare.
Let's go, guys. Keep going.
What was the request?
What was the request?
What did I ask for?
You asked for medium.
You know it's undercooked. You still serve it.
There's the medium one.
That's what I heard.
The next one on the list was medium rare. I'm sorry, chef. I gave you the wrong one.
It's now up to assistant maitre d' Craig to keep the diners happy.
Okay. I don't have a problem. You took a chair.
Yeah.
You took a chair. You hit this lady. You hit this lady with the chair. You are going to apologize.
Miss, I'm sorry. Did the chair hit you?
Yeah, it's okay.
I'm sorry. I'm not a violent person. I don't try to hit people.
While Craig does a little damage control in the dining room, Chef Ramsay looks to the red kitchen to get out entrees.
Two salmon, one beef, one Wellington. Oh, wait. Sharon, you've got raw meat against cooked meat. Gently, Sharon.
Yes, chef. Every time Sharon screws up, if I have a fish on that ticket, then I screw up.
But I need to refire those salmon. Sharon, how many wins minutes do you need those two salmon?
1 minute. 1 minute.
1 minute? 1 minute only.
Where's the fish?
Coming up and pan right now. 2 minutes, chef.
In Chef Ramsay's kitchen, every dish on a table must be sent out together. If one item is not ready, the whole ticket must be remade.
You and you are putting the kitchen in the
Yes,
Can
chef.
You move and wake up a bit, please, yes?
Yes, chef.
You're both pissing around like a pair of Barbie twins. Sharon, you're scaring me. You look like the female version of Hannibal Lecter. Put your tongue in and concentrate.
Yes, chef.
Hannibal!
While Sharon and Christina discover that blondes don't always have more fun, Chef Ramsay is ready for the blue team's entrees.
Where's the lamb?
The lamb is right here.
Cut the thing then!
Right in half?
Oh, come on! Now! Top and bottom it, yes? That lamb is beautifully cooked.
Thank you, chef.
Don't your pants.
It's been 20 years since I've cooked on the line. That was very nice of Chef Ramsay to compliment me on that. You know, that was nice.
Service, please.
Finally, the entrees are leaving the Blue Kitchen.
How is it for you, sir?
Thank you.
The sauce is really nice.
You'll like it.
It's delicious.
And the Red Kitchen.
Service, off you go, big boy. Let's go.
The chicken's delicious.
Where's this just come from? Who just put this ticket on here?
I've just brought this up to the...
What? It came on nearly an hour ago. Oh, no. Oh, no.
To be perfectly honest with you, chef, I have a line of tickets waiting for you, and I don't want to bombard you all at once and give them to you.
What?
I didn't know it was this hard. So, this is really difficult.
Pat, what time was the table written first time round?
They've been here for 2 hours, Chef, to be perfect.
What?
Yes, Chef.
Everything you touched?
Yes, Chef.
While Roseanne tries to get her act together, Chef Ramsay has a simple question for the men.
Where's the beef?
I got one beef right here, Chef.
Where's the other beef? Where's the beef?
You got a halibut yet? I have beef.
You said I only got one beef, Chef.
You, come here. You, come here.
Yeah.
So, can I have 2 beef, 1 halibut, 1 John Dory, and can we have it together?
Yes. How would you like those beefs cooked?
Oh, my God.
1 medium well, 1 normal. I asked for 2 beef.
Okay.
1 halibut, 1 John Dory.
There's one, so you need one more.
I want them together.
Okay.
I asked you to communicate with each other.
Okay.
And you're not.
Just let me know what's going on, please. Let me know what's going on.
You guys got to start communicating, guys.
Unbelievable.
Come on.
Well, let us do it. Petroza, how long? Why are we fighting? Everybody just calm down and focus.
I think there was a lot of communication problems between everybody. I mean, everybody's yelling. It's just chaos.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
As a lack of communication brings the Blue Kitchen to a standstill, Chef Ramsay turns to the Red Kitchen with a familiar question.
Where's the beef?
Sorry, Chef.
2 salmon, 1 beef, 1 Wellington. Unbelievable. What, have you asked Christina?
No, I did it. I did it earlier. I thought it was coming. She just yelled it was coming.
So you're not really a chef, are you? You're just a showgirl with a big feather coming out your ass. Well, she's going to set this place on fire. What the are you trying to do? Can't win in here, so you set the place on fire.
No, that's
not. Is that
not
your little
chef.
Motive?
No, not at yeah? all, Chef.
I've never seen such flames for a gnocchi.
Sorry, Chef. Won't happen again. This is raw. Okay, yeah, we'll do another one for you.
This yeah? right here?
Oh, that's table 31, Chef.
What?
This is not cooked.
Blue. Come here, you! Oi, all of you, come here! You stop. You've given up. You're setting the place on fire. And you're sending me raw fish. It's cold, it's raw.
It's not mine.
It's not mine. How dare you? It's just come back from the table.
Oh, okay.
Shut it down! Get the out! Shut it down! Get the f*** out!
After another disappointing dinner service, Chef Ramsay gets right to the point.
Bang! Meltdown. Pathetic. Really pathetic. I've studied the comment cards. The losing team. Other ladies. The guys sent half of your entrees. Not brilliant, but a damn sight better than the women. The best of the worst. Corey, you woke up. Finally, there's something in there. Corey, very nice that risotto.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank God for that. Go back to the dorms and think of 2 of your team up for elimination. I don't think it's going to be difficult.
I love being best of the worst. Hopefully, you know, it's not like that's the greatest title, but it's something and I'll take it for now.
I mean, I know Sharon's one of the people going up. Who else would there be to put up in our group besides Sharon? I doubt if she put Chris up.
The main person that sparked my attention, who I'm always worried about, is Sharon, AKA Barbie. She hasn't been able to execute nothing properly yet. She's not ready to stump with the big dogs.
But I don't know if she would put Sharon up, even though I say Sharon is the weakest link, because, you know, they're the makeup queens and it was buddy-buddy like a little bit in the beginning, so maybe that she don't want to put up for that reason, you know?
Right.
I wouldn't be surprised if she put me up or not.
I feel a little nervous because somebody's going home tonight. It could be anybody, but I'm just trying to be positive and hopefully telling myself it won't be me.
Everybody's want to kiss your ass now?
Well, I'm actually really surprised that no one has come up to me and had the try to convince me to keep him here, because you want to go home, dude? No problem sending you home.
You're going to take out the best, aren't you?
I am the best.
Corey, Have you made your decision?
Yes, Chef, I have.
Tough one?
Not at all, Chef.
First nominee and why, please.
My first nominee for strategic reasons is Christina.
Christina.
She treats me like a dumb blonde. If she was really that smart, she might want to take a deeper look and actually look inside me, past my appearances, and examine what I have inside of me.
Second nominee and why?
My second nominee, for personal reasons, is Jen.
Me.
As best of the worst, Corey's first nominee for elimination was Christina. And her second nominee was...
Jen.
Jen. Cool me.
I've chosen Jen because she distracts me from doing my job perfectly. We're working in a serious kitchen. We're here to win a serious prize. I want her out.
Okay, the gloves are off. Christina, Jen, step forward, please. Christina.
Yes, Chef.
Why should you stay in Hell's Kitchen? Seriously.
Seriously, I should stay in Hell's Kitchen because I am intelligent, Chef. Because if I am condescending someone, being Corey, she needs to come tell me. It's not something I do to her to be personal. I will get better, and I will fight for it. That's why I should stay.
Thank you. Jen, why should you stay in Hell's Kitchen?
It's unfortunate for me that you don't get to see what goes on when we do prep, Chef. I'm a beast back there. I know what I'm doing. I work hard and I get my food out. I maximize two separate ice creams and cook them, the star anise and the milk ice cream. I maximize on the time that I have, Chef. I got 4 pans of prep, meat out my souffle. I told you snacks, the skillets, the sizzle platter. I deserve to be here. I'm sorry. I'm gonna shorten it up, Chef. It's a lot of stuff that you don't know, and I've worked in Belgium. It's so much creative stuff that I can. And I just really ask that you give me the opportunity to show you, Chef, because this is not the end for me. It's really not.
Breathe.
I'm breathing, Chef. Might I say one more quick thing, Chef?
Oh, me.
All right.
Before I make my decision, there's something I'd like to say. This is one of the most important prizes ever. An executive chef's position in my own restaurant. I am not just gonna give this job to someone that I do not believe in. And there's someone here that I just don't believe in. So the person leaving Hell's Kitchen is... Sharon. Come here. Back in line, you two. Two services, you haven't convinced me that you can cook. Take off your jacket and leave Hell's Kitchen, please.
I don't think Gordon liked me from the start. He just had the wrong image of me. But I'm not gonna change anything about me. I'm not gonna give up on my dream. I'll have my own restaurant one day. I'm a chef right now for a reason. I'm not gonna give up.
Corey, I appreciate your strategy, but I have a conscience. And in good conscience, I could not keep Sharon. Tomorrow's another day, a fresh start. Good night.
Night.
Hell yes, Jen is still in the building. And you know what? I'm glad Corey did that. That right there woke me up. This ain't no game, this ain't no joke. This is crunch time, the gloves are off.
I feel like I was betrayed by my teammate. I think that sucks. I am absolutely gunning for Corey right now.
Gentlemen.
Yes, Chef.
Good night.
Good night. Woo! Elimination was a dangerous game. Anything can happen in Hell's Kitchen. Hands down, we got the vantage right now.
Sharon clearly showed great attention to detail. Unfortunately, it wasn't for her cooking, it was for her makeup.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen.
She ain't getting rid of me!
Corey's nominations lead to all-out war on the red team.
But you said it was vindictive and hateful.
Shh, Corey, she is a dumbass blonde.
But the women are in agreement on one matter.
Anybody want to come in the hot tub?
Using their womanly charm to bring down the men.
We're not here to play and grab ass.
That just ain't cool.
At dinner, the men's feuding continues.
Don't tell me to shut the up. I'll knock you out.
The women fall apart.
It's raw!
I can't believe he's done that.
And for some of the chefs, the stress is too much.
This is all I know how to do.
Do you want to go home?
Yeah, I'm done.
And if things weren't bad enough.
Oh, no.
Watch yourself.
Don't burn the kitchen down. Stand back! Stand back!
It's stressful.
Oh.
It's dangerous.
Get out!
It's just another day in Hell's Kitchen.